The latest 3D title offered a great variety of some strange and nice characters to meet. With the special art style of this game, we got to meet a bunch of colorful characters, both in their appearance and with their personalities. The surface didn't have all that much to offer, but the people of the sky, and mainly Skyloft, gave us a lot of side quests and other opportunities to interact with the different people. We're the Owners of Triforce, I'm Owner One, and let's take a look at the 5 coolest and weirdest characters from Skyward Sword. In the beginning of the game, Link finds himself at an academy, the Knights Academy to be exact. He's not the only one who's training to become a knight, as there are a lot of other people who also try to reach the same goal. Some are jerks, others are nice. For our number 5 coolest, we chose Pipit. Pipit is a very gentle and honorable man, always showing interest for whatever Link has to say or wants to know. He doesn't really do all that much, but we find it kinda interesting that he's the one in his family who actually makes the money, while his mother is the lazy one. There's a side quest where you help her clean the house, and she pays you with the money Pipit earns. This leads him to get furious with her, and we actually get to see a side of him that we didn't really expect. In addition to this, it's funny to see his reactions when he hears about Colin writing a letter for Karone, and how he tries to deny that he's interested in her. Plus, it's really sweet how they end up together. Early in the game, you hear rumors of there being a monster in Skyloft. This monster turns out to be Bachro. I hope I said that correctly. A creature that looks pretty much like a demon. He's actually really nice though, but he can't live among the rest of the inhabitants of Skyloft, because everyone's scared of him. He wishes to become a human, and does that after you've collected enough gratitude crystals for him. Bachro, in his demon form, actually does look kinda cool. Except for his tiny eyes and silly voice, of course. Hey. But he actually becomes weirder when he becomes human. His demonic traits are still there, like with his hair being shaped like horns, his teeth are still kinda creepy, and we have no idea what happened to his eyes. We're not sure if they disappeared, or if he's just keeping them shut. Either way, Link's silent reaction lets him believe that he's taken an amazing form of a human, but Link's reaction was the same as ours. Bachro looks weird. One thing that I personally really liked about Skyward Sword was that you could upgrade weapons and items. To do that, you need to meet Gondo in the bazaar. Gondo is this huge guy who loves to tinker on stuff, either if it's upgrading or repairing your items, or even fixing up an ancient robot. He's really enthusiastic about his work, and he's pretty much always happy to see Link visiting him at the shop. He's just a really happy and helpful guy, and we gotta love him for that. At a school, there's usually a bully, and it's not rare for that bully to have one or multiple companions. Groose is the bully at the Knights Academy, and he's got Colin and Stritch as his companions. They're both kinda weird in their own ways, but who lands the 4th place on our list? Oh, that's definitely Stritch. To be a guy who hangs out with the baddest man at school, he's not really that intimidating. In fact, when he's not around Groose, he's totally different. He loves bugs. That's all fine, but he's really into it. The way he talks about them is kinda weird.
I just really like bugs.
And he even dreams about having which he finds later in the game. If his love for bugs isn't that weird for you, just take one look at that huge nose and incredibly weird haircut. He puts Lloyd Christmas to shame. One of the best things you find in Elden Volcano is just one of the coolest races you can find in any Zelda game. I am talking, of course, about the Mogmas. These creatures are really laid back and are all hunting for beloved treasure. We absolutely love their attitude, their voices, and how they're really helpful to you, both in the outside world and inside dungeons. So, which one do we pick? Well, all of them! Except Platts, Tubert, and a few others. Really? Another Lloyd Christmas hairstyle? Some aren't really helpful at first, like Bronzy, who tricked you because he wanted some treasure for himself. In the end though, after he learned that you helped out Silva, he became really friendly. Pretty much all of these Mogmas were really fun to meet, and it was especially cool to see them inside dungeons as well. Plus, their theme is so catchy. The Bazaar does, indeed, house a few characters that are worthy of being on this list. Next up is the fortune teller, Sparrot. Even though he's really good with his fortune telling, we can't help but find his appearance really weird. He seems to be really short, yet somewhat fat, and he has a pretty big head. The most hypnotizing thing about him is definitely his eyes, but the funniest thing has to be his mustache. We also find it kind of weird that he needs a crystal ball to gaze into. When his crystal ball breaks, you get a side quest to find a replacement. You find another ball outside the Earth Temple, which the first one might have come from. The thing we're wondering about is, what makes these crystal balls so special? Why can only his giant eyes tell the fortunes of others by gazing into it? Ah, well, let's just end it by saying that his appearance is the biggest part of the reason of him being our number 3 weirdest on this list. You didn't expect us to leave out a Goron, did you? You meet only 3 Gorons in this game, but there's no doubt that Gorko, the first one you meet, is the coolest one. You meet him several times though, since he wants to solve many historical mysteries on the surface. Him being a Goron in general already makes him a cool character, but we absolutely love his enthusiasm for every little thing that brings him closer to solve how things work. He's always on his toes and excited to see what the next thing he can find is. In the whole series, we've never seen such an interest and curiosity for anything from a Goron. His voice and movements tell us that he really loves what he's doing, and that's what makes him our number 2 coolest character in this game. The last character we picked from the bazaar is the general storekeeper, Rupin. We totally understand that shopkeepers want customers to buy their stuff, but his attention is at a whole other level. Whenever you move towards his shop, even slightly, he's there, with the biggest, silliest grin on his face and hoping to see that you find something interesting to buy. His voice is really high-pitched and sounds funny, and his reaction whenever you choose not to buy the item you ask for is priceless. His face goes from a huge grin to an "are you serious?" kinda looking face, before switching back to a laughing, idiot-looking face, and it's pretty hilarious. Whenever you walk up to him, he stands there, watching you, and whenever you turn your back to him, he just bends over with a You don't even need to walk far away before he does that, which makes it all the more funny because he might have to turn your back against him just to walk around the corner to look at the rest of the stuff he offers. His hilariously looking face, how he is all up in your face whenever you check out something, and his quick changing reactions make him a funny character, but also a weird one, because he tries really hard to make a sale. The 3 bullies go through some changes during the game. I already mentioned how Stritch turned out to be really interested in bugs, and Colin tries his luck with the ladies, which doesn't end up well for him at all. No matter which path you take with this letter. The one who turned out for the better was definitely Groose. He was the leader of this little group, and he was so egoistic that he wanted to save Zelda himself. We had nothing but hate for this douche up until he came flying after Link when they both went for the surface. While he shows a chain of hilarious reactions to this unknown world, he was still pretty douchey until he realized that he couldn't do anything himself to rescue Zelda, but he could still help out. He goes through a huge change, going from hating Link to actually acknowledging his courage and what he had accomplished so far. He creates the beast that is known as the Gruusinator and helps him out with fighting against the imprisoned. He stays behind to keep an eye on Impa, and really serves a big role in the end. He goes from being a bully with a huge ego to a man who understands what realistic role he can take in this huge quest, and completes his role to the fullest. Perhaps the best moment with him was when he ran in during the fight against Ghirahim to catch Zelda from hurting herself from a fall, and that it shows that he trusts Link in defeating Demise. The man he hated from the beginning ended up being a comic relief, in addition to a caring and important character in this great quest. Honestly, this character could have topped either list. Personally, I find Geryon to be one of the coolest characters in the game. Cooler than Groose? I'm not sure, but still one of the coolest. Only Chu beg to differ though, so he only appears on the weirdest list. He's number one though because, while he is really cool in my eyes, he's actually be cool because of how weird he is. That's pretty much why he could have topped either list. Geryon is one of the strangest characters we've encountered in the series. He's flamboyant and has an absolutely fabulous style, in a weird way, with white hair that covers one of his eyes, white lips, purple eye makeup, diamond earrings, really tight clothes, his behavior in general, his speech pattern, his overdramatic movements. This guy has it all. I honestly think it took one cutscene for everyone to see exactly how weird he is. He freaking teleports behind Link, walks up to him and whispers in his ear, before sticking out his ridiculously long tongue out. He really is an entertaining villain, as he can be really threatening, even though he doesn't always appear to be. You can definitely argue that he's one of the coolest characters in this game, or even the series, because I actually think so too. But can you really deny that he's at least one of the weirdest characters in Skyward Sword? We sure as hell can't. Thanks for watching.